If you're here right now, chances are you are interested in learning about how to get offered your very first Birkin or Kelly from your local Hermes boutique. So I am here to share some tried and true tips on how to help you get those bags. Now, unfortunately, getting a Birkin or Kelly is not exactly as easy as just like walking into an Hermes boutique off the street and being like, "Hey yo, you got me Birkins, can I have one?" Even if you have the money to spend, it's not that easy. You're going to have to be willing to put in a little bit of work, a little bit of time, effort, and money up front in order to get offered your dream bag. But these tips will definitely help you in getting the bag of your dreams. So tip number one is arguably the most important tip. You need to select one essay that you are going to work with from here on out. The reason that you need to select one essay is because sales associates at Hermes don't actually make any money or any commission from selling Birkins and Kellys, but they do make commission from selling other items. So a sales associate is incentivized to sell you multiple items before they give you a Birkin or Kelly. And so if you're going and you're shopping with multiple essays, you're spending $1,000 here, $2,000 there, unfortunately, none of them are really going to be inclined to offer you a Birkin or a Kelly, even if you've spent the required spend amount ahead of time. So you need to pick one essay, and I strongly recommend you pick a person that like you genuinely get along with. Someone that you vibe with, someone that you enjoy like chit-chatting with, because this is a person that you are going to see multiple times. So find someone that you have a genuinely good rapport with. And I think that the best way to kind of go about finding an essay is just, if you're starting your Hermes journey, just go into an Hermes boutique. If you're able to walk in, or if it's appointments required, you know, set an appointment up ahead of time and they will assign an essay to you. And just go in looking for a lower dollar amount item. I would say something under $1,000, you know, maybe like some fashion jewelry, like a bracelet like this. Maybe something from their homewares department, maybe like a little small SLG, but something small. So that way you can work with an essay, see how you feel, see if you genuinely enjoy working with them or not. If you're not feeling it, like, let's be real. We don't all like everyone that we meet. If the genuine connection isn't there, just don't buy the item and leave. Or if you still want to buy the item, it's something that you really want, because you should only be buying items that you really want, then go ahead and buy the one item, but at least it won't be something that's like a huge dollar amount. You know, you won't be out like $5,000 with an essay that you didn't even like. And so that way, while you're there, you can see if you get along. And generally, if you've been getting along well with the essay, they will offer you their contact information. They'll give you your phone number, email address, and you know, kind of ask them how they would like to stay in touch. But find an essay that you really, really like, someone that you are going to look forward to going back and seeing, because you're going to have to be asking them for stuff, you know, you're going to have to work together. So just don't force it if the connection isn't there. Now, the next tip is something that you need to keep in mind when you are meeting your SA for the first time. Do not ask for a Birkin or Kelly the first time you meet with a sales associate. I feel like it's kind of like Fight Club, like the number one rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club. Same thing with Birkins and Kellys, honestly. I know it sounds crazy, but you don't want the SA to feel like your relationship is so transactional. You don't want them to feel like used. And we all know what it feels like to feel pressured to give someone something, even if we can't, like we know someone really wants something from us. So like SAs are people too. Don't ask them about a Birkin or a Kelly on your first shopping trip. I would say like second, third, fourth visit is probably a better time to ask them about like, hey, can your girl get a Birkin? Now, tip number three, like we talked about earlier, like you're only going to shop with your one essay. And this also means that you should not shop online. So do not purchase anything from Hermes.com if you want that spend to count towards your purchase history. Now, shopping online is actually a great way to find some highly sought after items, because when Hermes restocks the website, like they restock it, you can find like Kelly to go's, you can find like highly sought after like SLGs and shoes. So definitely buy items that you want, but if you want those purchases to count towards your purchase history, since your sales associate is not making commission off something that you buy online, just avoid it if you can. But still, get the items you want. Like, I bought a little book from the online shop because it was something that I really liked, something that was cute, and I don't care if it counts towards my Birkin or Kelly purchase history. Now, once you've found an essay that you really like, unless you are like a big baller, you need to make purchases with your essay over time. I would suggest going back, depending on, you know, how much money you have to spend, like every other month or like every few months at the very least. So that way you're staying top of mind with them. You can check in, see what's going on with them, you know, ask them about their lives, ask them about, you know, vacation, their family, things like that. They'll get to learn about you too. And so that way you can go back over time and not just build up purchase history over time, but really build up rapport. It's all about building this like genuine relationship with someone that you really like talking to. So that way, whenever one of your dream bags does come up that they think of you and they're like, oh, I know Lily would love this bag. Let me call her because I want to give it to her because she's been so nice. And as you're making purchases over time, tip number 5 is really important because you want to purchase from multiple categories that Hermes offers. And it's really good to purchase from the high commission categories. Again, because that's going to make your sales associate happy. They want you to be nice to them, but they want you to help them make money too. So the high commission categories include fine jewelry, so any like silver, yellow gold, or rose gold jewelry. It also includes home goods, so that can be anything from like dishes and glassware to pillows and blankets to like their bath accessories. They've got lots of decorative objects. And again, if you're a big baller, they also have some really nice furniture. That's a little bit out of my price range, but that does exist too. And then also ready to wear. And I don't know why a lot of people say that they don't like Hermes ready to wear. You need to keep in mind that the ready to wear you see on the website is just a very small selection of everything they have to offer. I think, a bit of like a more modern, like contemporary dresser. I wear a lot of like black, white, you know, gray, things like that. And I seriously love Hermes ready to wear. It's a little bit out of my price range for like a regular basis, like let's be honest, but I really love their ready to wear. So if you have the money to spend, ready to wear is another great category where your sales associate earns a healthy commission. So they will be more apt to offer you a Birkin sooner rather than later. Shoes is also another good category. I don't think it's as high commission as fine jewelry, ready to wear, or home goods, but it's another one to help round out your purchase history. And it's important to buy from multiple categories, not just to make sure that your sales associate is getting good commission on the items that they sell you, but it's also important to kind of show that you are a loyal and dedicated customer to Hermes, because you want them to know that like you're a true loyal fan of the brand. They really like rewarding really good customers with Birkins or Kellys when there's someone who's really like dedicated to the brand, someone that really appreciates, you know, the whole house, not just the handbags. So be sure to purchase from lots of different categories to help your SA earn money and to help your purchase history look better. And now I'm pretty sure that you can tell from all of this that before you are offered a Birkin or Kelly, you gotta spend some cash. Now I know that there are exceptions to this rule and there are certain people who have been seriously so lucky, chosen by the Hermes gods, that they have just walked in off the street, asked for a Birkin or Kelly, and received it. I mean, it's kind of bonkers because sales associates don't get commission on those items. So they must have just been in a really good mood that day. Or maybe the person was just super, super nice. But even though it happens, it is the exception to the rule, not the rule itself. And the general rule of thumb is that in order to get offered a Birkin or Kelly, you need to spend a 1-to-1 ratio beforehand relative to the cost of the bag. So say the bag that you want is $12,000. You're gonna need to spend about $12,000 ahead of time before you get offered the bag. Now again, some people get very lucky. Some people get offered a bag after spending $5,000, $7,000. And on the flip side, some people get unlucky. They don't get offered a bag until they spend $20,000, $25,000. It really just depends on the clientele in your boutique and their inventory levels. If they have low inventory levels, but like high dollar clientele, people who are willing to spend, they're probably going to be giving the Birkins and Kellys to those folks. I know that's the case in my boutique in San Francisco because we have like the highest concentration of billionaires, I think, in like any city in the world. Maybe that's an exaggeration, but I know we've got a lot of billionaires and inherently a lot of millionaires here. So 1-to-1 ratio is not gonna cut it in my boutique. I think I've heard the same thing about like Sydney, Australia. Again, lots of wealthy folks there. Sometimes a 1-to-1 ratio is not exactly enough to cut it. But as a general rule of thumb, you're gonna probably have to spend about the price of your bag before you get offered a bag. So just go ahead and spend, but again, spend in different categories and just be sure to buy items that you really like. Now, number 7 is really important, and I actually think some people tend to forget about this because they listened to one of the earlier rules about not asking for a Birkin or Kelly on their first visit because they don't want to put off their sales associate. But at some point in time, you need to let your sales associate know in a kind way that you are really interested in getting whatever your dream bag is. If it's a Birkin 25, or if you're interested in any size Birkin or Kelly, let them know because they're not mind readers and you've got to tell them what you want so that way they can keep you in mind once the inventory starts to come in. But I think it's really important that you're not just telling them what it is that you want, but you're being specific yet flexible. Now I know you're probably like, oh my God, Lily, what does that mean? So that means you're being specific on the things that matter the most to you. Now, in terms of these bags, it's the bag style itself, Birkin or Kelly, or Constance, or like Mini Lindy. Those are kind of like quota bags, depending on where you live. There's the leather type, there's the color, and there's the hardware, and finally, there's the size of the bag. So for me personally, I want both Birkins and Kellys, but I'm pretty specific on the sizes. For a Birkin, I would only like a Birkin 25 or 30, and for a Kelly, I would only like a Kelly 25 or like a mini Kelly or Kelly Pochette, but like overall regular Kellys, I only want a Kelly 25. Now in terms of colors, I am open to different shades of certain color families. So my SA and I, we've talked about this and we've talked about it in detail so she knows what it is that I would like. Now in some boutiques, they fill out, you know, an official wish list for you. And in other boutiques, you know, you just kind of talk to your SA and they like write some notes down in your customer profile. But when I talk to my SA, for instance, I let her know that one of the color families I'm really interested in is light gray. So I would love a Birkin or Kelly in a color like gris pearl or gris mouette. And as we were talking about that, she was like, are you also open to darker grays? Like, what if I get like a gris asphalt or an etan? Like, are those something you would be interested in? And I was like, yes, I would love dark gray also. So it opens up a dialogue so that they get to learn a little bit about your personality. And also it gives them more flexibility. Like for instance, say you are gung-ho on getting like blue Frida. Okay, do you really know the difference between blue Frida or blue Zellige? Maybe, maybe not. So like give your essay options. So like, for instance, I am very interested in a light blue color like CL or blue pale or blue broom. And so my essay is like, okay, got it. Like absolutely love those colors. I love them with gold hardware. So, you know, you just let them know where you're willing to flex and where you're willing to not. And also there's no shame if you're not willing to flex at all on your options. But just make sure that you're not boxing yourself in way too narrow, because if you only want one bag and one size and one color, you may be waiting quite a few years to get one. So you just have to decide, do you mind waiting or are there other bags that would also make you really happy in the meantime? Now for tip number 9, it's really important that based on the things that you ask of your SA, that you are not wasting their time. Now this is not just related to Birkins and Kellys, but for instance, if you ask your SA to order in, you know, 2 pairs of shoes, you know, a blanket and like 2 pillows, if they get all the items in that you asked for and then you don't buy any of them, that's not cool. That's really going to upset your SA because they went through all the time and effort to get those items ordered in, you know, had to talk to another store. And again, they're doing it because they want to make money off of you, because SAs do make commission off of the items that they order from other stores. So you just don't want them to be wasting their time, because then they don't make any money and then they kind of might not like you. But even same thing with like Birkins and Kellys. For instance, I told my SA, yes, I am cool with gris asphalt any time. So if she comes to me with the Kelly 25 in gold hardware, in gris asphalt or a 10. And then I say no, she's gonna be like, oh, well, why'd you tell me yes? Like, oh, I could have given this to someone else. And the reason that matters is because in order for an essay to be able to offer you a Birkin or Kelly, they can't just offer it to you. They also have to get approval from their store manager. And think about it. We've all had bosses in this world. We hate asking for like favors from our bosses, and no one wants to be like the girl or boy who cried wolf. So they don't want to keep, you know, getting approvals to give you bags if you're not willing to take them. Now, if your essay is offering you bags that you didn't ask for, then by all means, turn them down. Like, that's actually a good thing because you're helping show your essay what you do and don't like. And they really appreciate someone who's got, you know, good taste, and they want to learn more about you and what would make you really happy. But again, just make sure, like, if they are offering you bags that are things are on your wish list or things you've talked about and you don't buy them repeatedly, at some point, they're probably gonna stop offering you bags, and they're gonna offer them to people like me, hello, who will buy them if you offer me something that's on my wish list. And then with all that said, you know, I've talked about it a little bit, but the 10th and final tip is to make sure that you're only buying items that you truly love. Again, going back to what we talked about in the beginning, that Birkins and Kellys, they're not guaranteed to anyone. You could spend tens of thousands of dollars in a crazy scenario and still not get offered one. So you just want to make sure that everything you've bought beforehand are items that you really and truly love. So if by chance you don't get offered a Birkin or Kelly, you're still really happy with the purchases that you made and that you don't have like sour grapes because you didn't get offered a bag. Now granted, it'd be understandable to be a little frustrated if you spent like $30,000 and didn't get a bag. But again, just remember, like, Hermes does what Hermes wants. So like, we are not here to tell them what to do. We will get what we are given. So just be sure to really buy things that you like, so that way you're really happy with your experience. Because otherwise you might grow to resent it, and you don't want to start buying things you don't like and resenting it, because then it won't be that much fun when you get the bag, because then you'll just be upset about all these other things that you bought. So only buy items that you love, because at the end of the day, shopping is supposed to be fun. It's supposed to make you happy. We're supposed to have a good time. I personally have been really lucky that my Hermes essay that I work with, I fell in love with her on day one. She is one of my favorite people. I genuinely want to ask her to be my real friend, but like, I don't want to cross boundaries because she's a professional, and I'm sure she's a very nice person, but I'm sure she's nice to me because that's her job, to be nice to me. So whatever, she does a really good job at it though. She makes me feel really, really good, and she's really sweet. She always tells me to stop by even if I don't have an appointment. She just makes me feel good. And so I genuinely enjoy going into Hermes. Like, in fact, I went like a week or so ago to buy a pair of shoes. And long story short, the manager was like, can you actually come back in a few weeks once we get the shipment in? Because there's something changing about the shoes and I want you to take a look at them in person first, you know, before you buy them. And I was like, sure, no big deal. Because I had a good time while I was there, even though I didn't get what I, you know, went to go purchase. I got to catch up with my essay for a long time. I got to hear about like her daughter and her husband. So it was really nice. So you just want to enjoy the process, right? Like, no one likes desperation, so don't be too needy. Buy things you like. Be nice to not just your essay, but everyone that works there. And before you know it, a Birkin or Kelly will be in your possession. Now, what do you think about these tips? Is there anything major that you all think that I left out for any of like you seasoned Hermes veterans? If so, please be sure to put it in the comments below, because I want everyone to have all the information possible. This is everything that I know about. Now, be on the lookout for a following video sometime in the near future where I'm going to explain to you why this system exists. There are actually a few different financial reasons, and I think it's really interesting because I've never really heard anyone on YouTube explain it before. So there's actually reasons for all of this. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found it helpful, please be sure to give it a little like. I would really appreciate it. And if you haven't already, what are you doing? Subscribe to my channel, so that way you can get all the latest shopping content about Hermes and other brands too. I like to do shopping vlogs, you know, product reviews, product unboxing, things like that. So if that's what you're interested, definitely subscribe. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. My name is Lily, and I can't wait to see you next time. Bye, everyone.